Hello everyone, this is Darren at GB Productions, and today I'm going to be doing something a little different. Popular YouTube video essayist Nando V Movies has started another collab following One Marvelous Scene and One Excellent Scene. In celebration of James Gunn's The Suicide Squad, he has started One Villainous Scene, a collab where anyone, literally anyone, can discuss a villain that we deem interesting enough to talk about, whether it be from cartoons, comics, movies, TV shows, etc. And today, I will bless you all with a scene from my favorite horror movie franchise and one of my favorite TV shows in general, Ash vs. Evil Dead. If you've been watching me for a while, it is no secret that I absolutely adore the Evil Dead franchise. Its abundance of campy and gore-filled humor never ceases to amaze me, no matter how many times I rewatch each entry. Now, veterans of the Evil Dead franchise may or may not be a tad confused at the thought of someone picking one scene of a villain to talk about, because the Evil Dead franchise isn't really chock full of antagonists to talk about. It's usually your cookie-cutter demonic monstrosity that our heroes tend to face off against. Or at least that's how it would look at first glance. There is at least one standout villain within this franchise that I do not see fans talk about enough, and that is the demonic entity known as Baal. Now, Baal, obviously being a demon, has done a lot of villainous things to a bunch of characters within Evil Dead, both physically and psychologically. And despite only appearing about halfway through the second season of Ash vs. Evil Dead, he most certainly makes a good first impression. Now, there are a bunch of scenes of Baal doing a bunch of evil crap that might be worth discussing. I could talk about the time he skinned an entire human alive, or I could talk about some of the moments where he's the most conniving and manipulative he can be. But no. The one villainous scene I want to talk about is this one. His one blink and you'll miss it moment. Okay, so in stories, whether it be in movies, cartoons, TV shows, etc., typically there are moments when the villain gets the upper hand on the hero. Maybe they pull a BS power-up at the last minute to save their skin, or they give us a certain revelation that catches the hero off guard. But this scene in particular is one that I just have to admire for being one of the most gruesome and brain-shattering scenes I've seen in a horror movie franchise. And it's something that only Evil Dead can pull off the way that it does. Now let me give you a quick rundown on Baal. Baal is not one of your cookie-cutter demons that I was speaking about earlier. He's not as much of a physical threat as he is a psychological one. Very early on in this season, he has been set up as a big deal for our heroes to go up against, to where even our resident demon herself, Ruby, fears she might not even be able to defeat him. He's someone whose main talent is to evoke fear and paranoia and suspicion amongst our cast, and in this one scene, the audience as well. Now at this point in the story, Baal has killed Pablo in spectacular Evil Dead gory fashion. Now Pablo is one of the most lovable characters in the show. He's a loyal and kind-hearted partner to Ash Williams and Kelly, all three of them making up our iconic Ghost Beater trio. And just when we think we have the ropes on him, and right before he is seemingly defeated for good, he leaves one massive screw you to our heroes and the audience. But our heroes come up with a plan to go back in time and save Pablo's life. And with a few mishaps and the sad departure of the recently redeemed Ruby at the hands of the evil 80s version of herself, everything seems fine. They save Pablo, they hop in the Delta, and discuss a way to get back into the present timeline. And then, the rug is pulled right from under us in the most Evil Dead way possible.
Kelly, book me. Pablo, you think because that book was inside you, some Sumerian rubbed off, like enough to read from the time travel passage in there?
Don't you worry, Effie. I got this.
I knew you could do it.
Oh yeah, I can do it all right. I just don't know if I want to.
What?
I said, I don't want to.
Hey, whoa, whoa! Whoa, whoa!
Better!
He literally slit his throat and pulled Pablo's flesh back like it was a fucking mask. For the love of God. And the scene isn't even over. They get ambushed by the evil 80s version of Ruby, who is for some reason carrying the good present-day Ruby's severed head. Just for shits and giggles, I guess. And only a few minutes later, we get this mind-shattering reveal.
Now where the hell is my Pablo? You call it hell. None of it's correct. But your tiny little minds cannot comprehend the reality of the dimension that your friend now finds himself in.
know, you almost had me. You really blocked off all my options. Well, most of them anyway. And it's not ideal being inside a dead body, but it's not an insurmountable challenge. Especially when all I had to do was convince the one man foolish enough to swallow my chicanery. If he went back in time, he could resurrect his dead little friend.
Flim flam and SOB. You played me like a cheap fiddle.
Oh, don't be so sore, Ash. There's no way you could have known. See, my transference was one of those blink and you'll miss it moments.
Not only did Ball kill one of the most beloved characters in this series in the most gory way imaginable, but he also continues to mindfuck us by literally unmasking himself in the most gory way possible. It's the perfect demonstration of what Ball can do. We were all in the passenger seat when it came to how much Ball can mess with one's mind. But this right here, we see firsthand at how diabolical he can really be. More so than the other crap he's been doing all season. And that is why Ball's Blink and You'll Miss a Moment is my pick for one villainous scene. Okay, I know this video wasn't, you know, all that long, because I kind of had to do this on short notice, and I'm currently dealing with another bunch of real-life BS at the moment, so. And yeah, and I know it's been a while since, you know, I've uploaded a video. Not that anyone watches these in the first place, but, yeah. I am coming back, and I'm coming back with a vengeance. I have at least two videos DC-related. Two DC-related videos that I'm trying to, you know, push out as quickly as I can. So, yeah, if you're interested in that, you know, do your clickety-clickety-click, you know, do your thing there. And if you, for some reason, enjoyed this video, be sure to let me know right down there in the comments below. Also, be sure to like and subscribe. This is Darren at GMB Productions, and take care.